Hi everyone, well today we're going to go through the process of disavowing links. So please, if you have any questions at all, put them in the comments and I will do some more videos to answer those. If you want the very quick version of how you actually go about disavowing links, then you need to go to Google and you need to go to this particular URL, google.com/tools/disavow-links-main. And it will take you to a screen like this, and if you already know the site that you need to disavow, then you can just click on this link and you can upload the file. But I'm assuming that most of you probably don't know how to do any of this, and so therefore what I'm going to do now is just go through the whole process from finding links to creating the file to uploading it, Also, there should be some links over here to some videos that I would recommend to go and watch for as well if you want more information from Google, where they explain more about what negative links are and the problems that can come about when people submit to this incorrectly. And then you can always come back to the video. Okay, so how do you find these links in order to be able to disavow them in the first place? So one way that you can do that is to go into the Google Webmaster Tools account itself. And so if you have never been in here and if you don't have an account, then I recommend clicking here to go and watch this video, which shows you how to set up like your Webmaster Tools account. So that's going to be the Webmaster Tools account for the actual website that you want to disavow the links for. So at the moment, we are in the Webmaster Tools for one of my websites, and to find some of the backlinks that this site has, then we would go into this section here, links to your site, and click on that, and that will take you to this screen where it will show you who links the most and your most linked content. Now we're just going to have a look and see that for the moment there's this particular website here which is creating lots of links to the site, and so we're going to come back to that in a minute because that's not a very relevant site for my website. And if you then want to see the whole list, or certainly more of the recent ones, you click here on this More button. More link. And it's going to bring up a document where you can then download the a list of all the domains that are linking to your website, or you can come here and you can download the latest links. And so then you have a couple of options. So one option is that you might decide to do it all by yourself, and you might decide to record everything in a Google spreadsheet like this. The other option is that you might take these links that you've downloaded and you might choose to use some kind of link tracking software. So there's lots of different ones out there. There's one called Linkity.com, and you can go in and put all your links in there. Linkity will also find links for you. And there's another one here called MonitorBacklinks.com. So if you want more information about these, then click on the links to the side that will give you, or certainly in the description below, and because there also may be a voucher or a discount to these programs in the links that are in the description below. And these programs will save you loads and loads of time because they find links for you. They also give you a whole load of information about what the issues might be with that link or not. But like I said, if you want more information about those, click on the link here and that will take you to a further explanation. Then there's other programs which are like Ahrefs, which also have programs that you can use in order to kind of assess links, but it tends to be a lot more expensive per month. And it also has lots of other things that you might not want. So you might already have this program and it might be part of it. Otherwise, you might want to use one of these kind of programs that is specifically, this one of the main functions is to be able to create these lists of disavow links. However, if you wanted to do it more manually, then like I said, you could set it up in a Google spreadsheet. And now we're going to have a look at part of the process. And if you'd listen to the video from Google, then they talk about how initially what you should do if you find a link that you're not happy with is that you should try and email the person to find out if they can remove it for you. Now, finding this email address can be quite complicated and incredibly time consuming. And regardless of if you use these other tools or not, that it can be like an incredibly time consuming process to actually email people. But even if you can get 10% of the links removed that you no longer want, then I've seen that actually make a positive impact on websites. But otherwise, the option is to put them into the disavow tool. And if you use one of these programs like Linkedin or Monitor Backlinks, then they will create this the text file that you need. Otherwise, in a minute, we're going to go through how you would actually do that. Okay, so if we go back again to here where I pointed out that there's this website that's linking to me. So this is an example for you. Just say you found, okay, there's this website that's linking to me and I don't want that website to link to me anymore. So you could put it in the disavow. But as we've said, if you can actually get the link removed, then I've certainly seen that make a big impact on sites. So if we go to this website, and you'll see, because this is a website of mine, I've put this link down here on purpose so that you can see how this works. So we've got website creation by Fruitful Online. This is a site I created years ago, don't really do anything with it, but for the purposes of this video, it just shows you how, because I've got that down there, I'm getting a link to my site from every single page. And the website this is linking to, I now just do SEO, I don't even do website creation or web design anymore, so I really don't want that link there, and I'm certainly not doing SEO on this site, and it's in any case, if I could have that link there, but it should be a no follow link, it shouldn't be a follow link, and it is actually what they call a follow link at the moment. So just say I had to email myself and say, can you please remove this link? Then the person you email has to actually physically like go into their website. They have to then find where that link is. You know, I found it here that's in the footer, and so I'm just going to completely delete that and update the file. So now that won't be in the footer of this website anymore, and that means that there's no longer a link. So that's gone now. So that's no longer linking back to my website, and eventually this 169 links here will disappear. Okay, so that's the process that someone's going to have to go through when you email them. So you can understand why a huge percentage of people don't even know how to remove the link for their website, even if they wanted to. It might be sites that really nobody is doing anything with anymore, and they don't even get your email. To firstly find somebody's email, I'll just show you what you would need to do in order to do that. Okay, so what you want to do if you want to try and find an email is you can go to, well, obviously you could go to the website itself, and you never know, it might be on there. Otherwise, you can go to Whois, and if it's a .com.au website, then you would want to search under the whois.com.au. Otherwise, if it was just a .com, you could search under whois. You might need to use other extensions as well if it's other countries' domain names. So then you would go into like who.is, and then you could put in, say, some kind of a domain name, and then you would click search, and it brings you back all the information kind of indicating that they're registered with GoDaddy. And if you scroll down, you'll see that the email here looks like it's probably a real email. So in a lot of cases, you'll get rubbish emails which You're never going to be able to email the person anyway, but in some cases you do get a real email. You can email them, request that they remove the link. Now, when you request for someone to remove the link, it's pretty important just to be really nice about it and apologize and say, look, you know, sorry for taking up your time, would really appreciate if this, you may not be aware that this link is actually on your website to my website, and because it's not relevant, then it would be great if you could remove that link. And in most cases, if you know, if it's a real person that you actually managed to get, and if they're able to remove the link, then they'll try, because they don't want something, they don't want their site to be linking to something irrelevant either. Otherwise, if it is some kind of blog network or some other thing, then it can be very difficult, and that's why we need the disavow tool, because there'll be a whole lot of links that are very difficult to get removed. Now, if a link, and if you're using these particular programs, it'll come up and tell you if a link is follow or no follow. If it's no follow, that means that we don't really have to disavow it because of the fact that Google isn't taking any notice of it anyway. However, sometimes nofollow links might turn into follow links. So look, there's no particular harm in disavowing it if you wanted to. So one of the things that's really quite difficult, and it's important to be very cautious, is to make sure that you're actually removing or disavowing the right links, because you don't want to disavow links that are actually helping your rankings. And so that's why these tools can be incredibly helpful. So I'm not going to go through right now how to do that, but you can click on the links to find out how to do that. And just know that it's something that you really want to take a lot of caution with. And if you're really not sure, then it's definitely a good idea to kind of ask somebody. Just put a question in the comments below if there's a link that you kind of really wanted me to check out for you. Okay, so then the next step is we've discovered all the link that we don't want. We've either downloaded the file from here, or we've kind of got our own spreadsheet that's kind of got all these links that we don't want. And now what you need to do is create the text file, because if we go into here, and this is the section we're going to go into so that we can disavow the links, then we're going to need to upload a file. In some cases, what you might find is that when you click on that, you'll find that they already have a file that's been uploaded. And so in that case, what you want to do is download the file first, so that you've got you know, say that all of these domains that have already been disavowed, and then you can use that to add all your extra ones too. Otherwise, what you'll find is that you'll, you know, click on this to disavow the links, and when you click again, obviously it's saying, you know, be cautious when you're doing this, and then you'll get something like this, so that then you can choose to upload the links here. Right, now if you have a PC, then it's pretty easy in that you just go to your notepad to be able to create a text file. If you have a Mac, it can be a little bit more difficult to create a text file. There's a procedure you have to go to, so if you click over here to this video, then you'll be able to see how you can create one of these .txt files. It has to be a .txt file. If you use the text editor on a Mac, then it will create what's called an RTF file, and that's no good. Okay, so now we're going to have a look at what this file would look like. So you can go to this document, which is support.google.com webmasters/answer264847, so that link up there, or you can just use what I've got here as the example. So this shows you what your text file should look like potentially, and you don't actually need to include the bits with the hashes. This is really just for your own information. So this bit here is really just for you, Google doesn't care about that. All that Google really wants is like this actual link here, if you're going to try and disavow just the link. Or if you're going to disavow the whole domain, then you put domain colon and then the domain name exactly like that. So you can see I've got a text file here, and it's got domain colon, and it's got all these different domains, and they are, say, the exact ones. I want Google to ignore this whole website. So if you put the domain there, it ignores the links, any links to your site from that whole site. And so that's something that I could have done for this website, because it was linking from every page of this website to mine. Or I could, if there was a particular page that had the links on, then I just put the link of that particular page. In practice, I've found that it's fairly rare that you would just put the link of that particular page. Most of the time, I'm having to put in like the whole domain. But there may be a case where there might be, for some reason, you might have a couple of links from a particular website that are okay, and then another one that is on that has some kind of anchor text on it that you don't want to be linking back to your site, so you might just want to prevent that link from linking to your site. Okay, so you've got your file ready, so then you're going to go into this section, you're going to choose the file. Okay, so I'm going to choose this file. Then I'm going to click submit. And if there is a problem, it will actually come back and tell you that there's a problem. But it said that I've successfully uploaded a file that contains 35 domains and no URLs. If I had put in individual URLs, then it will tell me the URLs there. So then you could click done, and that would be it. And then what you want to do is probably go back and potentially, depending on your site, because we find that a lot of these links come back. So they keep coming over time. You can keep finding more and more of these links that you need to disavow. So you might need to be checking it every week or every month or whatever, depending on your website. And then what you're going to do is come in here and delete this file and upload the new file. So you probably want to potentially, if you've kept a copy of it, then you can keep updating it, but otherwise you maybe download the old file, add the new ones on, and then upload it again. So when you upload it, it actually overwrites this one, and so you don't have to necessarily delete it first. You can just upload one and it will just overwrite the one that's already there. The Penguin update now is supposed to be a rolling update. So really the more frequently that you're updating this file with links, the better, and the more chance that you have that these links are going to be picked up and will be prevented, therefore, from, I suppose, affecting your site in the future. So I'm going to delete that for now because that's not relevant to that site. So if you've got any questions, please do put them in the comments below, and I will endeavor to make some more videos to explain anything specifically. Otherwise, in the description, you can find loads of links to the things that I've spoken about in this tutorial that just goes through kind of the whole system of how you disavow links.
Remember to subscribe, like if you like, and check out our SEO training courses. And we'll see you in the next video.